We're finally going to look at how to represent values in Java using an integer. This is the most commonly used Java primitive. The integer is big enough to hold most numbers that you'll use. The goal for this lesson is to learn about the ints data type, its size, and how we create it in Java. An integer is represented by 32 bits, or 4 bytes. In Java, we use the keyword int to declare integers. An integer is 4 bytes, or 32 bits. This is a number from approximately negative 2 billion to positive 2 billion. The actual number is 2 to the power 31, but this number is large enough to just call it 2 gigabytes. On a side note, 32-bit operating systems like Windows cannot have a file or memory larger than 4 gigabytes. This is because your computer needs one number for each possible addressable memory location. So only 4 billion unsigned possible locations on a 32-bit operating system, so 4 gigabytes. To create an integer primitive, we use the keyword int, not integer. This comes from C, and for some reason someone thought integer was too long to type out. We give it a name and possibly a value. In this example, we're using a number I picked out of a hat, 2,763,306. We can give the value as a decimal value, a binary value, or a hexadecimal value. I'll open our program again, and I'll add this. The first example is a decimal literal. The second is a binary literal. The third, a hexadecimal literal. We run it, and again, the values are returned in decimal. It's because we're not formatting the value when we're printing it out. And that's the integer. When you're doing any integer math, this is the type that you'll want to use. There's nothing faster and more efficient than the int. Next, we'll cover the last integer primitive type in Java, the long. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on dgu.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on dgu.com. There's a poll on the front page of dgu.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.